Hey everybody, so today I'm going to be making a video about Puss in Boots, The Last Wish, and I'm going to give a synopsis of it and why I love it, but before I do, I just want to say, spoiler alert, this video is loaded with spoilers. I'm not going to like directly spoil the ending or something, but if you haven't seen the movie, I'm going to talk about the movie. So if you haven't seen the movie and you don't want spoilers, please just save this for another day. But before we get into the video even further, I just want to take a moment to thank all of you for getting my last video to the 1,900 views, 1,900 views. That is amazing, and I'm very glad that we're spreading the word about this disgusting trend. And I also want to thank you for getting me to 1,930,000 subscribers. I am finally above 1,900 subscribers, so full 30 more subscribers. So thank you so much for that, and let's get on with this video. So I'm going to preface this a little bit. I'm going to say I work at a movie theater, and I'm very happy to work there. I get benefits such as free popcorn, free drinks, and I can get discounts on snacks and stuff. On top of that, I get free movie tickets, and I took advantage of the situation, and I went to go see Puss in Boots, The Last Wish, and I have to tell you, that is the greatest decision of my life. So here's my synopsis of the film. The main characters are all rushing through many obstacles to get to this wishing star, and when they all get there, you can only grant one wish at this wishing star, this magical star, and they all are fighting who gets the wish. But when they all get to the wishing star, they all come to the conclusion that they don't need a wish, and they don't need magic. Everything they ever wanted is right in front of them. Well, not everyone. This character here is the main antagonist.
You're an irredeemable monster!
What took you so long, idiot?
He has a lot of hilarious lines. We're going to get to those later. But anyway, he's the bad guy, the main real bad guy. Even worse than the other guy, we'll get to shortly. His wish is for all of the magic in the world. Very evil intent is obvious. But they all rally against him, the other characters, and they take this wishing map and they rip it apart so he can't make his wish. And he dies. The other incredibly important character is Death.
I'm Death, straight up.
Death is not a character that like follows them to the wishing star. He doesn't have a wish. He's there because he's trying to take Puss in Boots' last life away. He's a cat. He has 9 lives. He's down to one more. Death is quite annoyed at the fact that Puss in Boots never valued a single one of his lives. Imagine having 9 lives. That'd be amazing. But he didn't value a single one of them, and he says he doesn't die because he laughs in the face of death. When he's down to his last one, confronted with death, and he fights with him, he realizes he's not immortal. He cannot laugh in the face of death. After Puss in Boots and Death fight at the end of the movie, Puss in Boots gets Death down. And he realizes, he says to him, I know I can never defeat you, but I will never stop fighting for this life. Meaning he's literally fighting for his life. And Death realizes, hey, he's finally valuing his last life, and he lets him live. So that's the synopsis of the film. Now with that out of the way, I'm going to talk about why I love this film. I absolutely love Jack Horner. I remember when I was watching it the first time, I was like, I don't know about this character. He seems kind of, I don't know if I'm going to like him, but he has some of the most funny like one-liners I've ever heard.
You're not going to shoot a puppy, are you, Jack?
Yeah, in the face. Why?
You know, I never had much as a kid. Just loving parents, stability, and a mansion, and a thriving baked goods enterprise for me to inherit.
Seriously, are you having a hernia or something?
There are plenty more lines from this character that are just hilarious, but I have to just say, I love that someone on YouTube, I don't remember where, but they said that they like that this character didn't have like a terrible backstory that made him evil. He is self-aware about how evil he is, and they don't try to make it look like he was innocent at one point. He was not innocent. He was evil from the beginning. Another thing I love about the film is Death's voice acting. He's able, like, I just love that tone of voice that he has.
Puss in Boots laughs in the face of death. I find the very idea of 9 lives absurd, and you didn't value any of them. This is gonna be fun.
It really inspires me to like work on my voice acting skill. It makes me sit there and kind of go, I'm Death. It's something that I enjoy doing. I've always liked voice acting. I've been working on deepening my voice for the last like 2 years now, and I think I've made some pretty good progress myself. Anyway, moving on. Going back to the Death character, one thing that really kind of gives me chills now is the death whistle. That always plays. Every time he's near or he sees Puss in Boots, you'll hear that. And you look around and then you'll see him. And it's every time. It's actually quite chilling now. Like in real life, if I were to hear that just walking through the woods and I heard that, I would probably just be paralyzed with fear and just hold still. One more thing about the Death character. He is pretty much the reason I actually went to go see it, because I was thinking, hey, this movie looks kind of fun, but also furries on Twitter are simping over this guy, and I'm like, let's see if he's worth it. Well, he has the cool voice. He has the cool look. I speak for all furries when I say he is absolutely worth simping over. Go right ahead and simp for him. This video points out that there's a scene where there's a bell ringing. And they point out that it rings 8 times. 8 times meaning 8 lives. This is his 8th life. And apparently you hear bells before you die or something. And his last life, that was his last one. And the whole time the bell was ringing, it rang 8 total times. It's probably not a coincidence. It was very well placed, very subtle. So I gotta give props to the team that made that. Another thing that I absolutely love is the way that they censor words. Just look at these clips. It speaks for itself.
Grub, oafish, munching, minky, nugget, and your snooter.
All I smell is bullsh.
I just think that's super funny. I remember when I was sitting in the theater and I could hear people like laughing at that. It's funny. I don't really laugh out loud. I don't lol, but that was pretty funny. My other favorite thing is the Goldilocks and the Three Bears. I love their accents, but I'm very confused. Like, I feel like Goldilocks is Australian, but the bears are like British, or Mama Bears is like Australian. Like the accents are all over the place, but that's just a little side comment I wanted to make. Anyway, moving on. Actually, I think we're going to move on to the end of the video here. I really don't know what else to say. I love this movie. I have seen it 4 times. I work at the movie theater. I saw it 4 separate times, and I can't get enough of it. I mean, I'm going to take a break from watching it for a little while, but please go watch it in the movie theater while you still can. I don't know if it's going to be much longer, but it's going to be for a little bit. Please go watch it and show DreamWorks some love, dude. They did a really good job on this film. I have yet to see the original one, however. I am going to try to make time to do that as well. But I do want to also say, given that I work at the movie theater, I was actually able to get my hands on the official poster. Like, the official poster. The back is mirrored, and the front is, the front, you got the poster. It's this image that you're seeing right now. It's this poster, and the back is mirrored. So it's an official one. I just got to get a frame for it, and I feel very, very, very lucky to have gotten this poster. But anyway, that's pretty much it for this video. I just kind of wanted to make a video about Puss in Boots and talk about why I love it and why I saw it 4 times. I actually saw it more times. After my shift was over at work, I would walk into the theater and watch the rest of it. But anyway, I just sit in an empty seat because there were empty seats. I just sit there and watch the rest. But anyway, that's it for this video, and I hope you liked it. It's just me kind of talking about a movie that I love. And my next video is going to be, I'm going to make a video about my favorite animated films. And I'm going to just say, it's going to be Disney. It might not be Disney. We'll see what's in that list. I know Bolt's going to be in that list. So anyway, thanks for watching, and I hope you liked the video, and subscribe if you want more content. See you later.